Hello there, folks. Welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It's Francesco here, and today we'll be diving into how to week plan in Bento. I wanted to give you a guided tour of some of the ways you can take Bento just that step further and using it in a sort of more clinical fashion to plan maybe some more prioritized goals across the next couple of weeks. Now, obviously, we're working on different ways that this could be optimized even further inside of our methodology, which we'll be releasing soon. So, are you looking to week plan inside of Bento? I want to give you a little bit of a tour of some of the most recommended ways to do that and how to get started. So I'm very excited, and as you can imagine, let's jump into today's video. So one of the ways that you can use Bento is obviously through our sort of daily Bento box, where you create three tasks, one large, one medium and small one to work on in a day. But there are ways to go a little bit step further, and we'll sort of outline these a lot further inside of the course that we're launching very soon. We can dig a little bit deeper. But I wanted to show you how you could potentially go about a little bit of goal sort of week planning inside of the app right now. So if you haven't got the app yet, it's available for iOS. You can find the link in the description. And our Android now has a wait list, so you can sign up to that below. Now, Bento is an app that we've created, just for full clarity. and we've been working on it for just over a year now. And we're super excited to be sharing it out. So I have Bento here in front of me, and what I've actually gone and done is created the setup that you can create in this video. Now, as you can imagine, I just wanted to briefly show you how to create a box. So you simply press create new box, and what's prompted to start is a workflow. Now, a workflow is simply the order you want to complete them in, and this can be based on your energy levels. For example, you start the day off and you want to accomplish the first thing that hits the to-do list, then you can start with your large task and finish with your small one. Vice versa with slow burn, it starts with small, goes to large. So in this case, I'm going to press climb that summit, it's middle ground. And as you can see, a box is created. Now, as you can see, you can add a large, medium and small task, and that's all that you can add inside of a Bento box. We limit you to three for a reason, to focus on prioritization and naturally reduce task overwhelm. So it complements most of the to-do apps or other experiences that you're currently using. It's a layer on top of that. It's a methodology and a framework that you can use across your day. So let me take you to the three boxes I've created for week planning. So this is my today, a good example of this. As you can see, I've changed the emoji to the sun, which is really nice. And the good thing is, if I wanted to just basically reset this box, I can hold down. So I don't actually have to change the boxes up on a routine basis. I just have to change the tasks inside of them. So as you can imagine, one thing I can do is enter each one and put a large, medium and small task. And I've already done that. I've got write, report, email campaign and yoga. Now, obviously, as part of the sort of week slash goal planning, you can keep this fairly simple. So this is only three box setup. You can do a seven box setup, which I'll show you a little later in this video. So the secondary box I've created is a week one. And now naturally I can add in three goals that I'd like to accomplish for the week. These are more like objectives, and sometimes being able to see them next to your today area can be quite efficient, particularly because if you're focusing on those three things here and they're the things you want to do for the day, and then you swipe right and you see the sort of week goals, it's nice because you're very close to home on your goals and your objectives. So you can see here that I've added three: reach a sub 6 minute mile, achieve M2 project and 4 day streak of yoga. So you can see that obviously some of them correlate to some of the stuff that I'm doing in today, but naturally you could use them as guidance. If you started with say your month goals, you could work back all the way to your today. And as you can imagine, pretty useful. Now again, I've done this with the month one, change emoji out to direct hit, and you can see here that run 35 miles, get promotion. Obviously, I might be fairly close to the promotion if I complete this M2 project. And then attend a yoga class, because maybe I'm using those other sessions to build up to that. So you can see here, it's quite a nice little sort of week plan, because one of the things that I think, obviously we do this naturally with tasks, but we also overcommit to projects as well. Overcommit to sort of goal planning. We go like, oh, I want to get this 10 things done in a month. And realistically, sometimes it's not necessarily possible. So having this sort of day, week, month view is quite nice. and it can really help you to just be able to see them side by side. Now, the other way that you could go about this is by using the Monday to Friday setup. So for example, if you created a box, you could call it Monday, and you could start adding the tasks in and naturally create Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So you can create up to 7 boxes in Bento. So you can have a full week inside of your Bento account. The good thing about this is you can just hold down and like we said, you could change the workflow based on how much energy you got, or just simply reset the box as well. So that's another alternative way to do it. I mean, if you're somebody that likes to plan, say, 3 days in advance because they don't want to advance a little bit further than 7 days, then what you could do is Monday to Wednesday, or create a new box for each new day. And then, for example, create a week and a month one. Or if you're focusing on work, then you could do the full 5-day work week, and then a week and a goals one for your month. So naturally you can adapt it to how you want. It's very new Bento for many people. So the good thing is that people are exploring the possibilities of how they can use it. But primarily it's for task focus. I just wanted to give you an expanded way to use it if you're already using it for focusing on your priorities. So hopefully you enjoyed this video about how to do weekly planning inside of Bento. I'm really excited, and naturally this application continues to find different ways that people are using it. So if you do have a moment and you are enjoying the app, please do leave it an App Store review as well. You can share some of your feedback. We'd honestly love to hear it, and whether you're loving the application so far. Anyway, folks, big thank you, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheerio.